training. There's Laura doing in some handstands. How you doing, Charter? I don't even see the straddle. The one arm. We're both going to be one arm training today.
Jeez.
Hey, Timothy, what's up?
How's it going, people?
How's the sound? How's everything? Let me know. Better side.
Is it your right?
Yeah, alright, yeah, so better.
My left is weak.
Yeah, I'm doing good. Laura, how are you doing? Someone just asked how you're doing.
I'm good, thank you very much. How are you?
I feel like it's a phone call. Alright, what's up guys?
Okay.
What's up? The back games. Gonna do some planche. Figurative planche, I think, if my elbow's alright. Maltese and front lever. Maybe, probably touch front lever pull-ups. Just quick one. I trained yesterday, so I'm pretty tired. We're just gonna get this in quickly. Yeah, my voice is a bit quieter. Okay, hold on. I think the music's probably just loud. Well, I'm just talking quietly because I think I'm tired. The music should be a bit quieter now.
Should we check that?
Up to you, yeah. Is it okay? Hey bro, Theodore. What's up? What's up guys? Right, I'm gonna warm up because I'm, you know, working towards the one arm handstand still. Before I was doing it on the floor in my video. Now, I'm gonna try and do it on parallax. I'm gonna try and learn, because it makes sense to learn it on parallax just because that's what I'm always using pretty much. So, yeah. So we're gonna do some one arm handstand stuff for like 10 minutes. Just working that. Solomon, hey, yeah, same. I did squats for the first time today and an interesting experience when you come from outside, yeah. But nice hitting the legs, we like it. We like hitting legs. But my left arm, my weak arm. Close. Yeah, same. I did squats for the first time, yeah. We're at that. Nice. What's up, people? Laura's turn. So Laura's also working on the old one arm handstand. Jack Vegan best basic exercises that I can do to strengthen myself for planche. Yeah, basic, depends how basic you mean, but you know, pseudo planche push-ups is gonna be good. Pseudo planche push-ups, planche leans, straight arm exercises, even just like, support holds on the rings is going to help. Any straight arm exercise that conditions your wrists and shoulders, that's going to be good. Yeah, overhead presses as well. Yeah, work your overhead presses.
hungry now.
Sorry?
I'm getting hungry.
It's starved.
I haven't even started like now. I'm hungry.
Such a roast.
Is it easier?
Yeah.
I don't know.
To like move side to side.
I think so, yeah.
It's harder to get up though.
I feel like when I was learning it the first time, yeah, I had my hands close when I was learning it on the floor.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why don't you let your head to a more neutral position? I don't know, I can't even tell my form at the moment. This is a skill I'm still learning. Would you suggest to get my V-sit higher and backwards towards mana? Yeah, if that's one of the skills you want, Timothy, yeah. Demios, what's up? Hey bro, will weightlifting help me in my Castanets journey? Is it a good addition to doing Castanets? Yeah, doing some kind of weights. It is good if you do want to mix it. Yeah. I would say. I need to down a little bit. Yeah, weightlifting, yeah. If it's muscles that, you know, help with the calisthenics exercises like overhead press, stuff like that, it's gonna be helpful. Bro, I saw the challenge you did with one arm handstand, very motivated. Oh, thanks, man. Have you ever attempted the one-arm planche? I've started working on it, but not properly. Do a real straddle handstand while switching and do it on the floor. Is pulling over because of what? Swimming. Hold on, let me do a set.
I'm gonna do this one on the floor.
Nice shot. I'll do my weak side first. That's my weak side. Right side is way better. Alright. What's up, people? I'm strong, thank you, man. Khalil Uchiha, nice name. Yeah, weight training, good for calisthenics. Oh, you wanna see me do the backy pose? What's up, vegan? Is it Pam? What's up? You wanna see me do the backy pose? I'd like to see myself do it. I've tried it before, it's freaking hard, man. I did think about doing a video on it. You have to push more, get your shoulder close to your ear, rotate. So, yeah. On my left side it's really hard to do this. On my right side a bit easier, but you know, this is only my second day going back to it since I did my challenge a year ago. Yeah. Okay, we're all caught up. Why is so? I mean, it's kind of funny that a soccer guy. Like, at least he doesn't spam.
It is a bit weird, but at least he doesn't spam. I mean, if he did spam, yeah, that'd be it.
I think I'm gonna put this down.
What was the joke?
Huh?
Is it a joke? Never mind.
And that was a bit better. Felt better. Your face.
My face will say it. I don't know, it's just, it's really hard one to get. Like, in terms of, like, form, I don't know. It's just a weird one.
Come on. I haven't even warmed up my wrists. No worries, just analyzing to help you. Yeah, yeah. I'm all good for the help. How many times a week do you train Maltese? And how many iron crossbow? I'm gonna train Maltese a decent amount. So maybe like 3 times a week, but very high volume. So that it's not intense at all. Iron cross, I did 2 to 3 times, but even that, you have to be careful because my elbow's like starting to get painful now just because of all the wide straight arm stuff I'm doing at the moment. So I'm trying to be careful. Would I be able to do advanced calisthenics movements without adding weight? Just pure body weight? Yeah, yeah. Well, advanced calisthenics movements without adding weight. What movements are you talking about here, Solomon? What do you mean by that? I'm losing weight to begin. Yeah, that's gonna help you out. Who is this girl? This is my girlfriend, Laura. She does calisthenics as well. Lauren.
It's close enough.
It's close. Laura. You can call her Lauren. I'll allow it. Nah, you don't suck, man. Where are you from? The UK? From the United Kingdom? Damn, calisthenics couple, that's so cool. Yeah, I take credit for getting into calisthenics.
I mean, you're fair enough. I don't really have much of an argument.
I mean, she could have handstand before I met her, so.
Well, yeah, I could. I tried it in lockdown, and then I couldn't do it, so I tried it again. December last year?
Wait, show them a handstand skill. Like Daniel Fleffo and Marlon. Yeah. W couple. Wait, show them some handstand stuff.
Pressure? Okay.
No pressure.
Bear with them, I'm dying.
No pressure.
Yeah, I'm gonna move some stuff.
Why do you train the left arm? No one cares on what arm you stay on as long as you do it nicely. Because I want to train both, man. Like, who wants imbalances? No one wants it. I get no one cares, but I mean, just for my own, I know I can learn on both, so why not? I don't want to do it like it easy. Hold on.
Okay, I'll do the like owl thing.
Yeah, just do it. What's your max handstand hold? I don't know, like. 45 seconds? Laura can do like over a minute. I'm like not great at handstands. Better to train both. Yeah, better to train both. Germany, big calisthenics community.
Oh my god, that hurts your core.
don't know why. I find parallettes much harder for one arm. I find it easy on the floor. I don't. Can you do a Hephaesto? I haven't trained it. I could do it. I'd probably do it if I spent like 2 months training for it, but I haven't trained for Hephaesto. It's not a skill I kind of want at the moment. Do you use weights to train legs? I did, but now I don't use weights for legs. I kind of do body weight stuff. I work them in planche. I used to. I prefer to focus all my energy and focus to one arm because in the end, this is the skill. Yeah, I get that, but I don't know, creating imbalances in my body, it doesn't sound good in the long term to me. I want strength on both sides. So it doesn't matter on the situation, it doesn't matter if I hurt one arm, if the other one feels good, I can still hold it. What do you think the hardest calisthenics skill is? Inverted cross, probably. Or inverted butterfly. I can do one leg planche. Oh, hey, Colette. I can do one leg planche for 5 seconds. Advanced tuck for also 5 seconds. Where should I go from here to progress better and get to straddle? Increase your advanced tuck. The better your advanced tuck gets, the better base you'll have for straddle. So get your tuck to like 8-10 seconds, maybe even more, and you're gonna get straddle for free. But then, and also work your glutes and increase advanced tuck. Make sure you have straddle mobility, and you're gonna get straddle for free. Basically, it's always a strength game, so you gain more strength and you'll unlock it. Should I train my strength first before doing statics? It depends. Like, can you do solid amount of push-ups? Can you do push-ups, pull-ups, dips? Can you do like 10 pull-ups, 15 dips, 30 push-ups? If you've got that base, I would start working on leans and work my elbows. That's what I would start doing. So it depends where you're starting. My dream is to handstand and do clear nose split one arm, but it's hard. It's hard to balance. I do progressions and I hope to achieve it. By the way, I tried to do handstand. If I tried to do handstand, will it work? Yeah, keep working on it, man. What do you do for cardio? Usually, I'll just do, you know, I'd run on the treadmill or I'll do the rowing machine. Yeah, those kind of things. How about advanced push-ups? Probably it would make it easier to do a straddle after doing it. Yeah, planche push-ups, I feel like other exercises can help more unlock it. But yeah, advanced planche push-ups, definitely, it would definitely help. Personally, I think some other exercises are better. Just because you're bending your arms, the fact you're bending your arms, you kind of lose working on the straight arm, but as long as you have your straight arm strength down, then yeah, it can work. Do you do weighted basics? Not at the moment. I actually haven't done it in a while, but to be fair, I really should. Did like a little gymnast twirl.
Nice little spin.
Little twirl. How do you train mobility for V-sit? Hamstring flexibility. So for V-sit, like, whether this is called pike for the hamstrings, or you could probably also do pancake or just like seated on the floor. Yeah, almost. Aren't your arms straight? Are they bent?
They feel straight. I don't know, you tell me. Do you train the hamstrings for more flexibility? I find pike press stands and the best looking entry. I don't really do pike press. I never really liked it. I always wanted the planche press instead. So, you know, the pike press wasn't really for me, but I did learn it. And I did have to train hamstring flexibility 100%. 100%. I'm going to do a few more sets and then planche.
Yeah, I might have to call it after
this. I was really bad. I didn't even probably warm up my wrists. Don't skip your warm up. What's the best way to train tendons for planche or iron cross? Very slowly over time. Putting them under load, giving them a long time to recover. Yeah, I'm probably going to make a full video on that at some point to break down the science of it. Because I think that would be useful. How's you guys' day been, everyone? Mine's been busy, but it's been good. Oh, bats and biceps important for planche. Biceps is important. Your back comes into it in terms of your upper back for protraction. But besides that, not very much. Because I can't tuck planche, I started doing it with elastic bands. Is this going to help me achieve it? Yeah, that's definitely going to help. As long as you use it right. Alright. So warming up for planche. Is gonna die.
My charge is dead.
Okay. You're gonna sleep now, see you Solomon, man. Your girlfriend's strong as fuck. Thanks, man.
Thanks.
She said thanks. You're destined for greatness. I know your channel's about to grow tenfold, remember. Remember us when you're finished. Thanks, man. Appreciate you guys. Good night, Solomon, man. Have a good night's sleep. I'm gonna quickly get this workout in. Getting a little bit of shoulder pain. I'm not sure what. I think it's from iron cross. I think I'm getting the shoulder pain from iron cross. So I'm really trying to make sure that I warm up my my shoulders a lot. So I would be training it today as well. I'm just going to do Maltese, because I think training high cross and Maltese same day, I think that's tough. It hits a lot. When live with Barkhar, yeah, I don't know, message him, get him on with me, I don't know. I'm training one arm handstand as well, and one thing that is helping me a lot is to focus on the hand you're going to release, just focus on the hip alignment to shoulder, yeah, I mean, there's a lot to focus on. What's the best exercise for shoulder protraction or scapular protraction? Scapular push-ups. Scapular push-ups, basically. Just spam scapular push-ups. So starting a push-up, scapula. Starting a push-up, scapula. Full protraction. Then do your leans. Do your leans, scapular push-up. Scapular push-up in your leans, and then you can add a band. So you can add a band and do it in push-up as well. Or if you get stronger, you can do it in tuck. Like that. So just spam the whatever variation is difficult. Yo, I had a question about balancing blunt high volume training. Yeah, ask away, Kevin, man. Nice to see you again, man. Luca, nice to see you, man. Yo, bro, I'm on 15 seconds front of a hold with a 4 to 7 kg band from Gore Nation, and have 3 second front lever. What should I do? So you have 15 seconds with a light band. I would also, what's your maximum front? I think my maximum front lever is probably around 20 seconds. Probably somewhere around there. 20 seconds fresh, 25. Somewhere around there. What was your question? Just keep going. Keep going with the using the band. And it's going to help when you don't have a band. Try grease the groove. That helped me a lot. So just do front lever throughout the day. That helped me unlock it even better. But do that and do drop sets. So you do your front lever hold, then get throughout that light band, do extra seconds. And over time, you'll get stronger. Just make each workout each week harder, basically, is what I would suggest. Use the bands, but don't use them the same way every week. Every week, try and make it a little bit harder, or hold 1 second longer on a certain band. That's what I'll say. I don't even know why I'm warming up the parallettes, so I won't be using the parallettes. I really feel that in my biceps, man. My biceps really hurt recently. I don't need to plug my phone into charge. So I can see what you guys are saying. What are you people saying? Let's have a look. Late night of you in here. How do you think I should approach it? Oh, so many questions. What do you think is the best way to progress on bent arm planche? And is it better for progressing in planche than using bands? Surely? No, bent arm planche is a different skill. Bent arm planche, different skill. So,
To progress with bent arm. Is that your question? If you want to progress with bent arm, it's the same thing. You just progressively make it harder. Gain that base, increase the seconds, and then make it harder. And then keep doing that.
Do you need this?
No, I don't need it. I think I'm using a rubber band. Bent arm, if you keep training bent arm planche, it won't get you planche. They're different skills. By the way, I can hold shadow on a higher bar for around 15 seconds. So should I do more shadow raises to work my way to front lever? Front lever raises are negatives, I think this will help. Yeah, if you can do raises. Man, why advanced tuck front lever pull-ups so freaking hard? I'd say just add a band, man. Or, you know this exercise? If advanced tuck front lever pull-ups are hard, try this. Try this one. Yeah. This one's easier. There's less core engagement, more just pull. So you really get to feel the pull. No false grip, just pull. Try that. I should also warm up my pull to do that. What's your favorite calisthenic skill? Probably dragon planche. Yeah, probably dragon planche. Dragon planche or fingertip planche.
Instead of bands, you can use rope and connect it with a belt. Yeah.
Honestly, just use bands. Bands make it simple. If you don't want to... Basically, if you can make a pulley system, make a pulley system. But honestly, bands are easy. They're easy to set up and take down. Really good video coming for you guys. It'll be coming this weekend. Really good video. Hold on, I need some water. Coming back. Just had to get some water. Right. Form was okay. Again, I'm feeling weak. I trained yesterday, so feeling weak, man. These days when I have to train after each other, they're hard. But those are the days where you get, you know, get stronger. So I train Monday, train Tuesday, rest Wednesday. That's kind of what's going on. What's going on this week? What do you guys think of the straddle? Do you have a strict diet? Not really. I mean, I'm vegan, so that's kind of strict in itself. Almost, it's naturally low calorie.
it's naturally like not very it's not very fatty, not very high calorie, so just generally how I eat is you know, is already enough. Impressive, very good form and good hold, thank you. I can hold front lever with a 25 kg elastic band for 30 seconds and sometimes even higher, but I can't hold it with 15 kg band, but the form is kind of bad. Yeah, the 25 kg band for 30 seconds, that's a lot. If you see my recent video, you'll know that the 30 second plus, that's endurance. You're not really going to be working on your strength at that point. You're going to be working on the form a little bit, but you want to be working more in the 15 second range. That's kind of where you'll find like the balance between, okay, I'm getting stronger and I'm getting to fix my form because you're actually in the position longer. So, but not too long. You don't want it to be too high volume. Right. I need to get my wrist right. How much does it cost to rent a flat in the UK per month? It depends where you are. Depends where you are, maybe like 800 to over that. Yeah, probably around 800 plus. Yeah. 800, 750, probably cheapest. What muscles are used in the Iron Cross? I can do the Iron Cross where you hold the rings on the outside of them. Iron Cross uses your biceps, your shoulders obviously, your upper chest, it uses strength from your tendon, your pectoral tendon here and here. What else does it use? Yeah, mainly those, your biceps, shoulders, upper pecs, and your tendons, mainly those. And of course your elbow, your biceps and your elbow tendons, those are under stress as well, holding up. Meliodis. Hey bro, can you give me advice? I have the tuck punch hold 5 seconds and did work on the shadow punch and make a little bit of progress, so I go and increase more or advance. Now, if you can only hold tuck planche 5 seconds, keep working on tuck planche. Get that to like 10 seconds, 15 seconds. You want a good base. Get your straddle planche stronger. I mean your tuck planche. Don't worry about straddle right now. Get your tuck planche stronger. Let me try another press, no hold. What are some good exercises for Iron Cross? Oh, that's a big question. Oh, the advanced tuck? Yeah, if you can only advance tuck for 5 seconds as well, yeah, still. Get that to 12, 10 seconds at least. And then start working your glutes. Start doing reverse hyperextensions to work your glutes, because you're going to need it in straddle. Like when I'm like, and work straddle leans, you can start working your straddle leans to get used to your glutes. Keep the hips down, don't have your hips up. Hips down, straddle, protract, working your leans. And Claire, Iron Cross. For Iron Cross, here's some Iron Cross exercises. But you want to take Iron Cross very slow. You won't be able to see very well. Iron Cross, so foot assisted. So I'm just gonna bend my knees. Just gonna bend my knees, load my chest, get my chest used to it. get my elbows used to it. You see that? I can't really turn. But I'm just bending my knees. Yeah? You could even just hold, put your elbows in, hold that, hold it quite high up. If you can balance it, hold that, like take your... Let me lose some of this. So you could put your hands through the straps, or for example, you could do this one. I think this is the one you're doing, where you put your hand through the strap, hand through the strap, and you hold like that. You could do that. You could hold just like this. So I lower down into it. And then you can go wider and wider to your holding line cross. You can put your feet onto a box and do presses. So you press up and down with your feet on a box. But you want to take it very slow. Again, don't rush this. And then these dips, Russian dips, I think. I did them yesterday, so they hurt now, but it's when you dip like this. So you don't dip like this, you dip out to the side, because that's gonna work these your pectoral tendons. Those are some good iron cross. But again, take them very, very slow. What do you think is the hardest achievable skill in calisthenics? Inverted butterfly, probably. How many times per week should I train the front lever? It depends on... I can't really answer that question because it depends how hard you're training. Because if you watch my videos, I go from high volume to... high volume to high intensity. You guys haven't had any music that whole time. Okay, give me 2 seconds. I'm gonna get my wrist straps. Give me 2 seconds. The music's probably gonna stop. Wrist wraps with elbow sleeve. I'm so hungry. I'm gonna put the elbow sleeve on. How's everyone doing? Do you watch Black Panther? No, I haven't seen it yet. Hey Louise, I love your channel. I'm getting up to shadow but can't hold it. Any tips? If you can't hold something, it's a strength issue. So identify where you're weak and then build a stronger base. If you can already hold advanced tuck, hold it longer. Then you're going to get stronger and then straddle pull is just going to get easier. It's all a strength game. Get stronger and you unlock a skill for free. I need help. I was training front lever about 4 months ago. I progressed to straddle from either. I can hold it 5 seconds. I don't know. Now I feel so heavy and sometimes can't even perform it. Make sure you're not overtraining. Make sure you're recovering, because you could be overdoing it. Yeah, that's a
That's a hard question because I don't really know how you're training. So just make sure you're not overtraining and make sure you're recovering. Because that sounds like it could be the case. Do you track your weight? Because you could be getting heavier. If you're getting heavier, it's going to make these skills harder. That's another thing. They're just setting up for Maltese. Do you ever do full plant, negative full plant press? I'm working on my straddle at the moment. Working on my straddle. Because, my straddle's, my pressing is like my weakest. I'm good at push-ups, I'm good at holds, but my straddle is like the weakest. My pressing, sorry. Alright. Let's go. Thanks for leaving likes, and if you guys are new here, subscribe. Try to hit 10k by the end of the year. By the end of the year? Well, sooner than that, hopefully, actually. So yeah, if you guys are new and you like this content, then subscribe. Get us to 10k. Should we warm up? We'll do one warm up. Green man. To Maltese, supersets. Don't know why that felt wide. I think my parallels aren't equal. Parallels on equal. When do you make a video on how to handstand? I might do it on Instagram. You know, like follow me on Instagram because I make reels on there to help with all these skills and for beginners. So if you're a beginner, Instagram is the place to be. The JackVegan_ on Instagram. Can you already do a handstand push-up? Yeah. Try to do your fingers wider. I don't think that... Nah, that feels good. It feels good having my fingers here. Wider is just... Nah, man. I feel like closer looks better as well. Do straight arm transition/holds for straddle press. Trust. What do you mean by straight arm transitions? What do you mean by that? The hollow body hold, how should I do it with my hands above my head or?
Should you do it?
Honestly, I don't know if it makes a big difference if being above your head or not. I know some people do it with weights in their hands to make it similar to the planche. Honestly, I think it depends on how specific you want it to be to planche. I want to do a pull set. We're going to do some pull sets over here. Tips for good finger strength, finger push-ups. Do knee finger push-ups. And then progress from there. Do your leans on your fingers. Where you're gonna see me here? That's lunch. Let's go, man. I give you all my power. Hey, Hugo, thank you. Doctor's calisthenics, or Doctor Calisthenics, you know, I'll try that. L sit to tuck press, spam that. You know, I'll try that at some point. I'll try that. If you guys are new here again, subscribe. Let's hit 10K. Yeah. I want my bars. Equal. Got the measuring tape. For Maltese, you've got to be accurate. So that's 4 and a bit. Okay, that should be about right. That should be even. God, why am I freaking airport for that? Right. As you do a tuck punch, look at my channel. What's the music? King Slayer. Okay. Let's go for 20 seconds. I'm gonna try and get that long. You see. It's gonna be very hard. Very hard. We need a new song. Cock. Hold on. Let me get a good song. Let me know if it's too loud. That might be a bit too loud. Let me turn it down for you guys. Alright. Let's go. I'm gonna aim for 20, or near 20, but it's not, I don't think it's really gonna happen. But you know, you can always hope. Fingertip. Thank you.
was like 15 seconds. I had to tuck my knees in. So yeah, if you guys are doing holds, just tuck your legs in to get longer. More time under tension. Oh man, that was about 15 seconds for both, but I tucked my knees in. The planche was not the cleanest, but 20 seconds is hard. Let me sit down. What AirPods do you have? I don't know, the Generation 2? Maltese is such a cool look, so yeah, I'm trying to unlock it. Oh, but it's tough. It is tough. I'm still trying to get my hand position right. The hand position is a little bit weird. It hurts sometimes. How long did it take you to do the full planche? About 3 years. Two and a bit. Because I stopped training over COVID and then I had to get straddle back. So it took me like two and a bit. 2 and a bit years. Let's go to.
Let's go. You hear the motivational tunes? I have no idea what this is. That was a weird remix, but okay. You know, one hit. Okay, 15 seconds touch, red band. So I've got the timer down here. I'm gonna wait until it's about 16 and then go into it. All right, 3, 2, 1. In this moment, I'm training planche too. Nice, you're training planche as well. Nice. How long have you trained calisthenics? I started in 2018. So, but I didn't train during COVID. So about 4 years. So I didn't train during COVID. So I had to relearn straddle planche. And then I had to get full planche. Back to planche. So I need to check my program. What am I doing? So I'm week two. So it's red band now. Red band for 16 seconds if I can. I got 15 on the first one. Kind of, like I had to tuck my knees in. I'm gonna write that down as well. Ooh. Yeah, if you guys enjoy the stream, hit subscribe. If you guys are enjoying the training. Always putting in the work. Yes, Anthony, man. How you doing, bro?
Do you think it's possible to increase my front lever hold from 6 to 11 to 12 in 3 months? It's doable, but in 3 months? I'd say it's hard, but it's doable. What's the point of doing planche hold easier before Maltese harder? I just want to get used to it. Hold on. Music's loud as fuck. Music's loud as fuck. Yeah, I want to just get used to it because actually in a competition, I want to do planche and then Maltese. And in a way, Maltese is harder, but it feels different. It feels more like an iron cross to me. It doesn't feel like I'm doing another harder planche. It feels like a different skill. So that's why I kind of do it after. I'm not gonna lie, in some ways planche feels harder than Maltese. But obviously, in general it's harder. But it feels like a different skill, so I kind of treat it as a different skill, even though it's harder. Front lever or straddle planche, what is harder? I mean, for me, straddle planche. But yeah, I think it depends on a person, but in general, I'll say straddle planche is, you know, about the same tier as front lever, if not a bit harder, depending on the person. Okay, red band. This song has a really long intro. Just gonna get my time. You guys ready? Are you guys ready? Let's go. What are we going for? 16? We're going for 16 seconds, but you know, this is gonna be hard. On the drop. Maltese. Oh man, I couldn't breathe at the end. I think I forgot to breathe. Because I am out of breath now. Good song for that though. Hello, first time on the stream. Nice to have you here, Andres. How long took you to unlock front lever? Probably a couple months. Probably within 6 months. Thanks, you too, Jack. Thanks, man. Can I unlock Maltese without planche? Yeah, people have done it. People have definitely done it, but it's very difficult. This podcast is getting you girls. Anthony says to get you guys. True. True. Again, like I said, if you guys are new, hit subscribe. We're close to 10k. Turn the music down a little bit.
Shall we go back to front lever? Or touch? I'm still out of breath. But I'm gonna do what? I think it's another 16 second hold. Doing touch front lever. Alright, let's do front lever. Let's do touch for 16 seconds. Red band. I'm gonna pull it a little bit tighter this time. You see how right now I'm going for the long holds. I'm going for the long holds because I'm going to work down to doing very short holds but without a band. So with a band, I'm going for like that 15 second around there. And then I'll get used to that over like 2 weeks. Then I'll go down to an even lighter band or no band for like, what, 6-8 seconds? And then the next time I do the workout routine, I'll start harder. So each time it gets harder. That's how I kind of do my training. I've written out my program. So, don't know if you guys can see, my program's there. It's on my phone, so I just follow that. Wrote it myself, and I just follow that. You guys, should we do a one-arm front lever? Let's do it on the drop. It's a good thump for it. Let's go. I don't know why I did that after I just did touch, but the song. Sometimes, you know, a good song comes on and you kind of have to. You kind of have to just hit that set. The song that just gets you fired up. Do you recommend training weighted dips and weighted pull-ups in the same day? Yeah, you can definitely do that. They're opposing muscle groups, antagonistic in a way. Right, we're gonna go back to planche in a sec. Oh man. So this is, I think, the last set. So over the weeks, I'll drop the amount of sets. So I started with 4 sets 2 weeks ago. Now I'm down to 3 sets because it's getting harder. And it stays at 3. 3 is like the minimum I go to until I start doing my attempts. Then I only do 2, maybe 3 or 4, depending on how I feel. So I drop the sets as things get harder. Because you don't want to keep, you know, you don't want to do like 10 sets or something that's super hard. I mean, there are times where that works, but for me, it doesn't work. That doesn't work for me. Right. We need the red band up. We're doing red band again, drop set.
So... well, this song's gonna... alright, we'll do this one. Okay. Just gonna go as long as I can. Wish me luck. Okay. We're gonna drop set. Add another band. Maltese coming straight away, superset. How to train handstand with parallels against the wall, probably the easiest way. No, it's not too useful. No, it's not too useful. You need if you work with bands, the trick is you need to keep making it harder. You don't want to hold too long, like 30 seconds, where it's too easy, and you need to make it hard enough where you still get the volume in to get better and get stronger, and then when you come back to do it the next time, make it harder. So this workout I'm doing today is harder than last week. The workout I did last week with bands is harder than I did the week before. That's progressive overload. So you keep making it harder. The same thing as if you're doing bench press, you wouldn't keep bench pressing? You wouldn't keep bench pressing like, what, 40 kg. You wouldn't keep bench pressing that until you hit 50 reps. You would go, okay, 8, let me add some weight. 8, next week, okay, let me add a little bit more weight. Same thing with bands, make it harder. Same thing. Oh man. Let's finish, man. Let's finish off. Let's go back to touch. Okay. Need red band again. You know what? Let's use this band, super light band. We'll try and do like 10, 12 seconds. Yeah? 12 seconds, 10 seconds, let's try. Super light band, touch from lever. I don't even have chalk on my hands, man. I'm gonna try and pull it a little bit tight. Just a little bit. That was about 10. I went into it a bit late, so I didn't get 12. That was about 10. Light wrist wraps, or the power wrist wraps. Hold on, let me get in shot. Let me sit here. So I've got the light ones on. I do have the power ones that you're talking about, the thicker ones. I like the light ones. So the light ones are soft. So when I'm doing like touch front lever, it doesn't rub so much. So that these ones are soft and they're lighter. So that means that I get more wrist mobility. You know how the thicker ones feel like they're so rigid, which is good. It's good when you're doing something like very hard. You'll need the support for it, or you have a wrist injury. That's when I use it. When I feel like I've got a wrist injury, that's when I start using the thicker ones. But for everyday stuff, I like the lighter ones. It's more mobility. It still provides support. So I like the light ones. But if you feel like you have weaker wrists, then the stronger ones are probably for you. Right, what we do next, guys? What's the 30-day push-up challenge? Is it the most push-ups you can do every day? I don't know what that challenge is. You know, we're pretty much almost done. I think I'm just gonna spam some straddle presses and then I'm gonna call it there. Cause I haven't eaten, I'm tired now, man. Maltese killing me. So I think we'll spam some straddle presses. And then we'll call it there. Rings out the way. We're just gonna spam the green band. This bar's done. Drop set. I'm gonna tuck. That was
100 or 200 push-ups a day for 30 days. Yeah, you're probably gonna get pretty freaking good at push-ups. Hey man, just a man of fitness, what's up? What's up, what's up? We need to do some front lever pull-ups. You can still see me? Yeah, nice. Oh guys, I'm shattered. So tired. So you're full punch without resistance bands now? You always man, Aman, you're always coming in here at the end of the stream asking for hard skills. I can't do them now. Oh, you follow on Instagram? Nice. Yeah, I post a lot of reels on there. So you guys will get more content there. You wanna start cooking?
Quite
sorry, hold on. Stop the music, huh?
Might be quite loud.
It's fine. Oh, I've got, what, maybe two more sets? Yeah, two more sets. Where did you buy the tool parallels? So we need some of those. This is from a place called Decathlon. They have a new version though. Alright. Second set. Might have to do tuck. I've never heard of street games. What days do you do live? Usually Sundays and Tuesday. Usually those days. Yo, can you help me? I've been dealing with golfers over for 2 months already. I think it's chronic. You need to go to a physiotherapist, man. Go to physio. Go to physio, man. Alright, let's do the last set. Last set now. I'm gonna use both bands. That's me done. I'm done.
Whew. That's pretty much it for the workout. So yeah, if you guys have enjoyed it, let me actually get in shot. If you guys have enjoyed it, then yeah, hit subscribe, try and hit 10k. Check out the Discord. If you guys are learning Castorian skills, check out the Discord, linked in the description of this stream. Let me get set my proper chair. It's in the description of the stream. So we've got the Discord, so Jack Castanets gang, loads of people in there helping each other. So if you're struggling with Castanets, join that. YouTube channel members, they get personal coaching. The price is going to increase soon. So yeah, if you join it, because a lot of people are joining now, the price is going to increase. So get in while you can. I'm helping people learn planche, front lever, a lot of other skills. So yeah. If that interests you, join that. That's pretty much it from me. Instagram, you can join me on Instagram. I post reels, the Jacked Vegan _. And yeah, that's pretty much all I have to plug. You'll check it out. What's my meal plan like? Yeah, any final questions, throw them in while I recover. My meal plan, I'm cutting at the moment. So I'm trying to get lighter. I was 73 last year, this time last year. Now I'm 68 kg. So I think I still will go a bit lighter. My meal plan, I'm vegan. So whatever fits my calories for the day, pretty much. How old are you and do you want to go to any competitions? I'm 26 and maybe at the end of this year, nearing the end, but it depends how busy I am. I'm like, yeah, very busy. So it depends how much free time I have, and I want to get combinations. Once I get this straddle press and full press cleaner, it should only take a few months. It should only take, like, I think by summer I should have it clean. So after that, I work on combinations, and then maybe I'll do competitions. I don't know in pounds how much it weighs. I don't know, 68 kg, huh?
No,
68. Nice. Nice. How much did it take you to achieve the planche? Took 2 years and a bit. I had to relearn straddle planche, then I got full planche, then I lost full planche, then I had to relearn full planche. Then the form was bad, then I had to relearn full planche again. But it took me about 2 years and a bit to get my first full planche. I cannot read that. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed the stream. Any new guys, hit subscribe. I stream every Tuesday, Sunday. I might miss a few days, but usually every Tuesday, Sunday, I'm gonna be streaming. So yeah. That's all from me today, guys. So I hope you've enjoyed the stream. And I've been the Jack Vegan. All right, move you with me. Hope you enjoyed the stream. And I will see you guys in the next one. See you guys.